is risen. Alleluia. And he has overcome death. It's Easter Daily Bread Devotions with Father Eustace Siame, a Salesian of Don Bosco. Stay tuned.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
It is Easter Wednesday of the 20th of April 2022, and participating in the proclamation of the Word of God for today are the following Daily Bread members. Michael Mbatia Ngigi, celebrating his birthday today from Nyahururu, Kenya, takes for us the first reading. Rahab Mumbi Wamai from Makuyu, Kenya, takes for us the responsorial psalm. And proclaiming the gospel is Father Harold from Zomba Diocese in Malawi. Let us pray. O God, who give constant increase to your church by new offspring, grant that your servants may hold fast in their lives to the sacrament they have received in faith. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever. Amen.
First reading. I give you what I have. In the name of Jesus, rise and walk. A reading from the Acts of the Apostles, chapter 3, verses 1 to 10. In those days, Peter and John were going up to the temple at the hour of prayer, the ninth hour. And a man, lame from birth, was being carried, whom they laid daily at that gate of the temple, which is called Beautiful, to ask alms of those who entered the temple. Seeing Peter and John about to go into the temple, he asked for alms. And Peter directed his gaze at him with John and said, "Look at us." And he fixed his attention upon them, expecting to receive something from them. But Peter said, "I have no silver and gold, but I give you what I have. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, rise and walk." And he took him by the right hand and raised him up, and immediately his feet and ankles were made strong. And leaping up, he stood and walked and entered into the temple with them, walking and leaping and praising God. And all the people saw him walking and praising God, and recognized him as the one who sat for alms at the Beautiful gate of the temple. And they were filled with wonder and amazement at what had happened to him. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Responsorial Psalm. Psalm chapter 105, verse 1 to 2, 3 to 4, 6 to 7, 8 to 9. And the response is taken from Psalm chapter 105, 3b. And the response is, "Let the hearts that seek the Lord rejoice."
Let the hearts that seek the Lord rejoice.
Give thanks to the Lord, proclaim his name. Make known his deeds among the peoples. All sing to him. Sing his praise, tell all his wonderful works. Response:
Let the hearts that seek the Lord rejoice.
Glory in his holy name. Let the hearts that seek the Lord rejoice. Turn to the Lord and his strength. Constantly seek his face. Response:
Let the hearts that seek the Lord rejoice.
O children of Abraham, his servant, O descendants of the Jacob he chose, he, the Lord, is our God. His judgments are in all the earth. Response.
Let the heart that seek the Lord rejoice.
He remembers his covenant forever, the promise he ordained for 1,000 generations, the covenant he made with Abraham, the oath he swore to Isaac. Response.
Let the hearts that seek the Lord rejoice.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Luke chapter 24, verses 13 to 35. That very day, two of the disciples of Jesus were going to a village named Emmaus, about 7 miles from Jerusalem, and talking with each other about all these things that had happened. While they were talking and discussing together, Jesus himself drew near and went with them. But their eyes were kept from recognizing him. And he said to them, "What is this conversation which you are holding with each other as you walk?" And they stood still, looking sad. Then one of them, named Cleopas, answered him, "Are you the only visitor to Jerusalem who does not know the things that have happened there in these days?" And he said to them, "What things?" And they said to him, "Concerning Jesus of Nazareth, who was a prophet mighty indeed and word before God and all the people, and how our chief priests and rulers delivered him up to be condemned to death and crucified him. But we had hoped that he was the one to redeem Israel." Yes, and besides all this, it is now the third day since this happened. Moreover, some women of our company amazed us. They were at the tomb early in the morning and did not find his body. And they came back saying that they had even seen a vision of angels who said that he was alive. Some of those who were with us went to the tomb and found it just as the women had said, but him they did not see. And he said to them, "O foolish men, and slow of heart to believe all that the prophets have spoken. Was it not necessary that the Christ should suffer these things and enter into his glory?" And beginning with Moses and all the prophets, he interpreted to them in all the scriptures the things concerning himself. So they drew near to the village to which they were going. He appeared to be going further, but they constrained him, saying, "Stay with us, for it is towards evening, and the day is now far spent." So he went in to stay with them. When he was at table with them, he took the bread and blessed and broke it and gave it to them. And their eyes were opened and they recognized him. And he vanished out of their sight. They said to each other, "Did not our hearts burn within us while he talked to us on the road? While he opened to us the scriptures?" And they rose that same hour
and returned to Jerusalem. And they found the 11 gathered together, and those who were with them, who said, "The Lord has risen indeed, and has appeared to Simon." Then they told what had happened on the road, and how he was known to them in the breaking of the bread. The Holy Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
When I reach readings like the ones we have today, I just don't know where to start from, because we have both readings very, very interesting and encouraging. They are reminding us of the effects, the beautiful effects of Easter life. If you are a child of the resurrection, you won't go opposite the path of Jerusalem. If you are a child of the resurrection and you are in Jerusalem, you will have something more to offer than just handouts, than just giving things to people who will come back to you again asking for help. You will give them, equip them with things that will help them in their own life. This is exactly what Peter and John do. They come to the temple, and it was something they used to do every time. They are confronted with a beggar, and they have to make this beggar understand that in the life of the resurrection, there are no beggars. People have to stand on their own feet. Here is the beggar, used to seek for alms. He's comfortable in his life of begging. He has built his own life of comfort, relying on the mercy of others, and somehow he's okay. He begs for help from Peter and John. Peter looked at him and said, "Look at us." You have to know the people you are begging from. These are people who have known the power of the resurrection of our Lord Jesus Christ, and they don't want anyone to remain in misery. Look at us. What do you see? Do you see temporary things in us? Do you see painkillers in us or healing? Do you see temporary things in us, or you see something that endures? Look at us. We have had a life different from what you are living. You are relying on hand-to-mouth kind of life. I want to take you out of this life. Look at us. Silver and gold we do not have. But in the name of Jesus of Nazareth, risen from the dead, who gives life, who makes things come to life that seems to be dead, I say, rise and walk. And we are told he took him by the right hand and raised him. And immediately his feet and ankles were made strong. So he did not just use the word, which has the power to heal, but he also used his hands. He helped him to come up. That's a role we have as believers. We are supposed to use our hands. If we are children of the resurrection, we are supposed to use our hands to help people come up. But we should help them come up in such a way that they don't go back to a life of a beggar. Sometimes we think by just dishing out money, we are helping people. We are not helping them. We are making them remain perpetual beggars. If you are a child of the resurrection, you are going to help somebody walk on his own feet. You are going to help somebody start doing things by himself, by herself, in the name of Jesus. And you will do that by taking somebody to school. You will do that by giving somebody a hole to dig, and not just the products of the field. No, make a person work. Make a person stop being a beggar and start taking care of others. That is the work we have. It is the role of every child of the resurrection, every child of Easter, to help others come out of their misery. Yes, charity is very important, but tell somebody to look at you. Look at me. Look at where I have reached. Look at what I have done in my life. I've not achieved this by just sitting down. No, I've not achieved this by just relying on what people give me every day. No, I have walked. And I want you to walk. Rise and walk in the name of Jesus. Silver and gold we do not have, but we have God. We are men of God. And if we are men of God, if we are men of the resurrection, women of God, we are supposed to give something to people that endures. The gospel passage of today is an experience of two disciples who were moving away from the Jerusalem that gives something that endures. Luke presents to us people journeying in the opposite direction of Jerusalem. The other presentation is what we find in chapter 10 of the Gospel of Luke from verse 25 about the Good Samaritan. Jesus gives that parable that a man was coming from Jerusalem to Jericho. The other story is what we find in Luke chapter 10 verse 29, where we hear of a man coming from Jerusalem to Jericho being attacked on the way. And he is attacked because he's moving away from the center. And now we see the two disciples of Jesus who were not among the 12 moving away from the center, discouraged, disappointed, and they are moving away from the source of life, going the opposite direction. Why? Because they are discouraged, they are broken, they stand for all of us who somehow, when we experience trying moments in our lives, we decide to move away from the center. Move away from where we can find God in our lives. And we start going into a direction where we think we'll find gold. We leave God to look for gold. And on the way, as we are looking for that, we start discussing the God we had in our lives who would have given us gold. And start lamenting about things that we thought would have worked well. And they never worked. Just relieving our frustrations. And this is what we see in Cleopas and his companion. Two disciples, one of them named Cleopas. At least we know the name Cleopas mentioned here. But we don't know the other one whose name is not mentioned. It could be the wife of Cleopas. As a disciple of Christ going back to Emmaus, they are frustrated, they are disappointed, and the other one could be any one of us. Name not mentioned, so that we put ourselves there. And as they are going, discussing all these things, Christ himself stood among them. He walked with them. And he asked, what is this conversation that you are holding with each other as you walk? Questions help to clarify exactly the nature of our conversation. When we are asked on our faith journey about the faith we have, about things we talk about in our own faith, we learn to deepen our own understanding. And Jesus wants this trend to continue, to have somebody asking us or asking yourself a question. What is this that I am talking about? What is this faith that I have? Because if you don't ask questions in your own life for faith, you will never understand the path you are meant to tread. And so they looked at him, baffled that he did not understand, that he was not aware of the things that had happened. It was common news. It was breaking news. It is like asking about Ukraine. What is it that is happening in Ukraine? What is it that has been happening with Russia and Ukraine? What is it that is making the world get concerned about what is happening here? People will say, are you the only one in our world today who does not know what has been happening? Who doesn't go to social media? who doesn't go to the news media, to the mainline news media, to understand what is happening in our world today. Ignorance is not allowed when it comes to big events that are happening in our world. And Jesus now passed through with them the scriptures. He wants them to understand. If you are to understand Easter well, go back to the Word of God. Don't relax. You have been feeding on the Word of God in the past 40 days of our Lenten observance. Let it not end there. Continue feeding on the Word of God for you to understand better what God wants you to achieve in your life. And he explained to them, as they were drawing near, he acted as though he was going on further, but they begged him, stay with us. A prayer they made, stay with us, Lord. And he stayed with them. We have not to give up on prayer. We should be praying more during this time than we even prayed during Lent. Oh no, Father, then what do you mean we should be doing? I thought now we should be relaxing after the prayers we had offered to the Lord. No, there is no relaxation in prayer. Tell the Lord to stay with us. Stay with us, Lord, for it is nearly evening and the day is almost over. We are looking at the things that are happening in our world today, and we have to say, stay with us, Lord. The day is almost over. It is evening. There is confusion in our world. Stay with us. They persuaded him to stay with them. And the whole point of this was to make the disciples to understand that from that time until today, they were going to understand Jesus, and we are going to understand Jesus in the breaking of the bread, in the liturgy, in the sacraments. Their eyes were opened and they recognized him. And from there, they went back to declare the works of the Lord to Jerusalem. Once you have Jesus understood in your life, you are not remaining in Emmaus. You have to go back to Jerusalem. You have to go back to the center. You have to go back and be with the rest of the community of believers. If you are not with a community of believers right now in your life, that is something wrong, because you have not met Jesus. If you have met him in the breaking of the bread, you will learn to value the small Christian community meetings. You will learn to value the guilds, those lay groups that help in deepening your own faith. Please do, if you are a child of the resurrection. We give glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Blessed Easter Wednesday to you. Hallelujah, hallelujah.
Thanks be to God. Hallelujah, hallelujah.